How's everyone doing tonight? We are back live at the Miranda Center for round two of the NCAA Division III tournament. I'm Zach Ford doing your play-by-play. I'm accompanied by our color analyst, Matt Cox. Matt, tell a little bit about the game we have tonight.
Well, we have a great one as last night in the first round, both upsets with Nicholas College upsetting the Newman Knights and Endicott upsetting Salisbury University. So, you know, two big upsets here, and we're going to get a conference rival matchup here as these two teams played in the CCC championship game. And in three meetings this year, Nicholas College has the advantage as they won two of the three meetings this year. So it's going to be a good one here, and I'm expecting a lot of physical play between these two rivalry teams.
Absolutely, yeah. Like Matt said, both of these teams know each other really well, basically evenly matched throughout the season. Endicott coming off a tough, hard-fought win against the number 16-ranked Salisbury Seagulls. Max Motroni and Kamal Walker led the way with the goals. Motroni had 18 points, 5 rebounds, 2 assists. He's a real well-rounded, scrappy player. And Kamal Walker really put the team on his back in the second half, carried his team to a victory. He finished with 32 points, 5 rebounds, 4 assists. Another guy at the guard position, Matt, that not big in stature, but plays like he's a 7-foot guard.
Oh, yeah,
dude plays with a lot of heart, both of them.
No question at all.
And for Nicholls College, another team that come out, they can play. They showed Newman is a team that likes to run in transition. They've done it all year, and it's been their focal point on offense. Nicholls proved early in the game last night that they can actually run with the Knights. They have speed the guard position. They start three guards, and Dion and Echevarria, they were up and down running the entire game. We will take a quick second here to honor America with the national anthem. We are back live here from the Miranda Center. Newman University hosting the tournament for the first time ever. As we will hear the starting lineups from both teams. It's looking as though Endicott's going to start the same way as they started last night's game. They're going to go Max Motroni, number 55 at the point guard. Number 2. Kamal Walker will be at shooting guard. Number 13, Steven Basden, will be at the other guard position. And at the forwards, number 24, Chris Lipscomb. And number 4, Daquan Sampson. Matt, Daquan Sampson coming to the game, looking like they were going to be, maybe he might be a player to watch. Got into a little bit of foul trouble yesterday. Let's talk about that a little bit.
Luckily his team bailed him out and helped. But I think especially in a type of physical game we're going to see today, Daquan Sampson, if Endicott wants any chance to win this game, is going to have to do his best to stay out of foul trouble, especially against a big guy like Jerome Cunningham, who if Sampson sitting most of the game like he did yesterday, this Endicott team is going to have a tough time against him.
And for the Nicholls College Bison, they're looking like they're going to start the same way as well. They're a really young team. They're also going to start three guards. They're going to go with number 1, Deontay Bruton, coming off a 28-point game. He's a freshman. Guard number 3, Tyler Dion, shot the lights out yesterday from 3. He's also a freshman. Sophomore guard number 4, Marcos Echevarria. He seems to be their spark plug. And then at the forward positions, number 22, the senior Devin Stallings, and the 6'8 freshman phenom, number 13, Jerome Cunningham.
Well, I'll tell you, all these kids can shoot the lights out of the ball. I'd like to bring up a point that you mentioned in yesterday's game, how most of this starting lineup is freshmen, which is incredible. You would think the nerves would kind of play a factor in yesterday's game. They didn't play that way. They played like these guys were seniors. So this team has a lot of talent, and they should be good for years to come.
Absolutely, yeah. Like Matt just noticed, they're starting a lot of freshmen. They actually go three freshmen, a sophomore, and a senior. It's pretty impressive that these young guys stepping into Newman's own gym and taking it to the number 11 team in the nation and knocking them out first round exit.
Yeah, and
their poise.
Not to bring up a disappointing stat, but it was the first loss this year that Newman took at home.
Yep, tough one to swallow for our Newman Knights here. But on to the second round as we await the tip off. Looking like it's going to be Sampson jumping against the freshman for Nichols College, number 13, Jerome Cunningham.
Max Motroni looks like he is a few words before tip-off there for his team. He's definitely a vocal leader to this team.
Absolutely. He's really what makes his team go. And I would say definitely Echevarria is that for the Bison. Tip one by the Gulls, and here comes Motroni. Lipscomb looks. Pass it to Kamal Walker. He finds Sampson. Back to Walker. He looks. Motroni. Now it's Basden. Sampson off the screen, gets the ball for three, and that's good. The big man making an early impact. Number four, Daquan Sampson, saying, give me all three of these.
How about that stuff with Daquan Sampson sitting out most of yesterday's game and making a crucial impact here to start it?
This is Endicott team. They're not the biggest team, but, man, they're scrappy. Stallings for three, and he answers. The senior, number 22, Devin Stallings for three.
We might see a three-point shootout here tonight.
Both teams showing signs of early offense here. Basden in the corner. He drives to his left. Back to Motroni. He ball fakes. Defended well by Dion. Walker jab steps. Gets in the lane. Sampson wants another one. Dials it up. Little long. Rebounded by Cunningham. I'm sorry. Gets the ball to the guard, Echevarria, who gives it off to the freshman, Bruton. Matt, tell us about Deontay Bruton last night. This kid did his freshman. He did whatever he wanted, and here he goes again with the right hand. Tell a little about what he brought to this team last night.
He's just an incredible athlete. This guy, I mean, he does it all. He can shoot and he can drive, especially against the Twin Towers of the Newman Knights. He just went by them.
Lipscomb dials it up, and that's good. Chris Lipscomb answers, giving the Gulls an early 6-5 lead here. Both offenses hitting from all cylinders here. It's got to be a good sign for both coaches here. Stallings finds Echevarria. This kid is quick. Back to Stallings. He wants three. And he got it. Give him all three of those. Stallings 2-for-2 from beyond. Walker pulls up for two. And that's good. Both teams, Matt, shooting the lights out here early.
They're explaining why they're here in the second round. Very quick start here for both teams.
Echevarria comes off the screen by Cunningham. Cunningham drives with his right hand, spins. Back to the right hand. Up and under move. Defended well by Sampson. Gets his own miss and lays it in. Jerome Cunningham.
Great job by Sampson. I know the basket went in, but great job to stay away from the early fail.
Lipscomb finds Sampson. He wants three more. Off the rim, rebounded by Stallings. The Bison looking to run. It's Bruton. He dumps it into Cunningham along the baseline. Cunningham backs him down, turns to his right, up and under. Spins back to his right and lays it in with a nice move. Jerome Cunningham again. Motroni drives, right hand, baseline layup, and that's good. Number 55, Max Motroni. We said his name a ton yesterday.
I'll tell you, I like that matchup in favor of Max Motroni with Tyler Dion.
Bruton drives to his left. He pulls up, knocks it down. Right, this kid does not miss. Kyrie's right over from last night's game.
I'll tell you, neither team's missing early on.
Walker drives with his right. Back to Basden from the corner three, and it's long, rebounded by Cunningham. Bruton looks to run. Bruton off a screen. Tipped away, it's going to be stolen by Sampson. He finds Basden. Basden looks ahead. Gets it to Walker. He drives with his right hand. Lays it up with the left, and it's long off the front of the rim. Dion pushes. Finds Echevarria, who pulls up for the spot three. And that's good. Marcos Echevarria for three.
Let's see how many times I can get that name right tonight.
Motroni to Walker. Lipscomb for three, and he answers. Chris Lipscomb, two for two from beyond the arc. Five minutes in here, 17-13, Nichols College lead over the Endicott Gulls. Echevarria wants three more, and that's wide. It's going to go out of bounds back to Endicott as we step away to our first media timeout. Matt, both teams here firing on all cylinders, shooting a very high percentage early.
Yeah, both teams showing they can shoot from deep, and really that's what Endicott needs here. I mean, the way we saw Nichols College yesterday, we saw that they can shoot the ball from deep, so Endicott's going to have to find ways to answer that.
Notice in Nichols College early, they're on fire from beyond the arc, but they're also getting the ball inside to Cunningham, who's basically just backing down the defender, Samson, just basically having his way inside.
Yeah, I feel like Jerome Cunningham's not going to have his way with Samson. I feel like he's definitely trying to keep his way out of foul trouble early on. I expect him to be more physical as the game goes along here.
Yep, so. With a player like Cunningham, he's big, he's long, he's physical. You got to be a little bit hands-on while defending him. He's showing his post moves early. He's up and under. He's going with the left hand. He's going to the right. He's getting his own miss. So he's showing that he wants to be pretty active early on.
Yeah, he's definitely a tremendous athlete and had his moments with Darian Barnes yesterday. And
that was a fun battle to watch.
Oh, it definitely was. And he got Darian Barnes in early foul trouble, so got to give a lot of credit to him.
Some early subs here for the Gulls from Endicott. Checking in will be Keith Brown, number 23, as well as number 21, Vinny Clifford. Both players come off the bench for this Endicott team and really can light it up from beyond the arc. Keith Brown showing yesterday he's not afraid to shoot, given a little bit of space. Here we go, Vinny Clifford for three, right off the bench. Give him off three of those. Early and often, right off the bench. Cuts the deficit to one. Bruton looks to drive. Echevarria looks in. Dumps it down to Cunningham. Cunningham spots up. Spin move. Going to be a blocking foul. Number four, Daquan Sampson. Going to be his first, team first.
A little tic-tac call there. Definitely a lot of contact. But.
Checking in for the first time tonight for Nichols College will be number 12, Josiah Kimball. Played some good minutes off the bench yesterday for the Bison as well. Bruton drives, left hand, and that's good. Petroni looks to answer. Quick drive. Vinny Clifford wants another one, and that's good. Splash. Number 21, Vinny Clifford. Six quick ones off the bench for the Gulls.
How about those bench points there?
Bruton finds Cunningham. He lays it in with the left hand. It's wide. Rebounded by Kimball's going to recover it and lay it in for two. Once the N1 doesn't get it. Walker drives to his right. Good pass into Sampson. Throws it down with two hands. Daquan Sampson.
There's that force they were missing yesterday.
Brown finds Sampson. Back to Motroni. Motroni steps back for three. And that's short. Rebounded by Kimball. That's Maria from deep off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Sampson. Then the goal is looked around now.
Got away with some contact there, too.
Yeah. Could have been a three-shot foul. Clifford wants another one. And that's up the front of the rim. Rebounded by Cunningham. Bruton, quick drive, finds Kimball. Oh, they're going to have another foul call. Kimball go to line to shoot two. Looking like the foul will be on number four. Yep, that'll be his second, Daquan Sampson, his second team second.
That's what this team is now looking for.
Sampson just struggling this tournament so far to stay out of foul trouble.
Nichols College definitely getting the idea here to attack him.
A rare free throw miss by the Bison, who basically shot lights out from the strike last night.
Yeah, they were incredible from the line, especially Enchevarria. I say that name right?
Yep, you got it that time. Good job.
All right. That's a good sign tonight, but he shot 10 of 10 yesterday.
From the line, yeah. As Kimball hits the second, checking in for the first time for the Bison will be number two. Sorry, find his name here. Daquan Antoine. And checking in for the first time for the Gulls will be number 11, Drew Sawyer. Great feed inside as Chris Lipscomb lays it in for two. Gives Endicott the lead here.
How about Walker creating plays?
Yeah, he's yesterday he was in more of the scoring role. Now it's looking like Walker took more of the facilitating role, as he has two quick assists.
I tell you, Bruton versus Walker, that's going to be a fun matchup to watch.
Cunningham drives. He turns to his right. Right-hand floater off the back of the rim. Tipped, rebounded by Clifford. Drew Sawyer looks. He finds Walker. Keith Brown for three, and that's wide to the right, rebounded again by Cunningham. Cunningham wants to go coast to coast. He turns and almost throws it back court, recovered by Echevarria. Back down on the block to Cunningham. He has the one, feeds it across. Antoine for three, and that rims out. Rebounded by Drew Sawyer. Clifford to Walker. Walker gets in the lane, ball's tipped out of bounds. And we'll stay here with Endicott as we head to our second media timeout under 12. Motroni, quick rest. He'll check back in. A lot of these guys, man, they got to be winded. Deontay Bruton last night for Nichols College, 39 minutes he played. Marcos Echevarria for Nichols. He played the entire 40 minutes, Matt. You think maybe late second half fatigue would set in here, or?
I mean, the way they're playing early on, it doesn't seem like it's settling in yet. But we could see some tired players coming towards the second half.
Looks like these guys just don't stop. They just keep going.
Yeah, they really don't. I don't know how they do it. I couldn't go 5 minutes on the court.
That's why we're over here behind the cameras.
Yeah, but I'll tell you that the way this game's going right now, I don't expect a bigger – this is just a guess for me, but I'm not – going to expect a bigger lead than seven in this game.
And it feels like, Matt, that's how both games went yesterday. Neither team, in especially in the Newman-Nichols game, neither team could really pull away the entire game. Newman would go up seven. We would blink, and now Newman's only up one because Nichols would answer six quick ones. Yep. It's just back in both teams. Nichols would go up five. Newman would answer. It was just back and forth the entire game.
Yeah, in both of those games, I think Newman had the biggest lead in either of those games at seven.
Yep. And that was quickly erased. Motroni to inbound. Clifford lets it go back court as he receives it. Basden looks, finds Clifford. Back to Sawyer. Right through Matroni's legs. And that'll turn it over and give the ball back to the Bison.
I think that got one of the coaches in the face down there.
right in the beak. Great defense, stolen by Lipscomb. Ah, but he steps out of bounds. Bruton checks back in for Antoine. Cunningham also takes a seat as number 24, Nate Tardy, checks in for Nichols College.
How about Jerome Cunningham staying out of foul trouble here early?
Yeah.
He had some problems yesterday with that. But
Echeverria is so quick. Swatted by Lipscomb. Great defense there by Chris Lipscomb. Five on the clock. Bruton steps back for three. That's off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Tardy. That's Maria with a nice drive. That's laid up off the back of the rim. Rebounded by Motroni. The extra pass works. Finds Motroni. He's fouled. He'll go to line to shoot two. Quick drive by number 55, Max Motroni. He's fouled by number one. Looks like Deontay Bruton. That'll be his first foul, team first, as Matroni's to the line. 1st one is good. Keith Brown checks back in as Vinny Clifford takes a much appreciated round of applause from his teammates as he has six quick points off the bench. Second attempt is good for Matroni. 25-22 Endicott lead here, about 10 minutes into the first half. Bruton drives. They're going to call a bump. You foul number. It's going to be on 1-3, number 13. Actually, scratch that. It'll be number 24, Chris Lipscomb. That'll be his first, team third. Stolen by Lipscomb. He's on the fast break, and he'll lay it in for two. Lipscomb really being active here on defense.
Yeah, he's a very aggressive player.
Echeverria drives. Floater with the right hand off the glass and in. Marcos Echeverria. Lipscomb to Matroni. Finds back to Lipscomb. Nice give and go. Count it and one. Chris Lipscomb off the great dish by Max Matroni. He goes to the line for the potential three-point play. That'll be foul goes on number four, Echeverria. That'll be his first, team second. Cunningham checks back in for the Bison, and Antoine checks back in. Great give and go there by the goals of Endicott.
Hashtag goal.
Hashtag go goals. Free throw is missed. Rebounded by the Bison. It's Echeverria now. Drives to his left. Gets it down to Stallings. Back out to Echeverria. He drives again with the right hand. Up and under. Lays it in for two.
Wow, that is an incredible move.
Keith Brown wants three. Nope, pump fakes. Matroni spots up. Keith Brown wants three. And that's off the back of the rim. Great hustle play by Matroni. Gets the offensive board. He hop steps in. Back to Keith Brown. He wants three. That's no good. Tipped away. Walker grabs rebound. And he'll lay it in with the right hand. Endicott is outworking Nichols College on that possession.
Offensive rebounds are going to hurt you.
Ball's thrown away. Turnover by Nichols College gives the ball back to Endicott as they lead by five here. About 8.5 to go.
I'll tell you, how about the job by Endicott here? Something that we did not see Newman do a lot yesterday, but they are guarding that three-point line.
Trying to make them beat them inside. Not a bad strategy. Like you said, you mentioned before the game, these guys know each other. They're in the same conference. Actually met in the conference championship. Nichols College winning by only 3 points. Lipscomb wants three. And that's short. Rebounded by Nichols. Echevarria wants three now. And that's good. Echevarria starting to heat up.
I'll tell you, a little bit of space is all he needs.
Can't say it enough with this team. They just keep finding ways to answer. Walker, wild layup. That's missed. Echevarria finds Dion. Dion to his right. Six on the clock. Antoine finds Cunningham. He's swatted. Oh, they're going to call a foul. Not on Lipscomb. It's going to be on the body. It's going to be number 13, Steven Basden.
Yeah, that was a no-brainer call there from Basden. Definitely grabbed Cunningham.
So we'll head to another media timeout. I thought they were going to call that foul on Lipscomb, Matt. I was going to be a little upset.
How about yesterday where Newman needed some mops, and they answered my call.
Our mop girl is really putting in a lot of work tonight. It's good to see. Doing a great job. It's not an easy task.
No, I believe it. I believe it. You gotta,
everyone watching you.
Somebody slips, it's your fault.
Absolutely. Those of you just signing in, about 7.5, just under 7.5 left to play in the first half. We have Endicott leading Nichols College 31-29 in the second round of the 2017 NCAA tournament here at the Newman University Miranda Center.
Both teams trying to receive their ticket onto the Sweet 16.
Echevarria leading the way here for the Nichols College Bison as he has 10 quick points.
I'll tell you, he can do it all, which is
smart. Yeah, he's very impressive. Should be the freshman Cunningham to the line. First one's good. Man, this team.
Yeah, I'll tell you, when
they hit their foul shots.
When he's hitting free throws, I think he was the only guy to miss yesterday for this team. When he's hitting free throws, you're in for a long night.
And he hits the second. All knotted up here at 31. Looking like the Bison here going with a little bit of a picking them up at half court with a little zone trap, it looks like, as they settle into man-to-man. Clifford for three, and that's good. Give him all three of those, Vinny Clifford.
How about that spark off the bench?
That's nine points for Clifford as he's 3 of 4 from three. Echevarria finds Dion. Dion hasn't gotten going yet. He was a huge spark for the Bison last night. Stallings misses. Rebounded by Motroni as it's tipped away.
Daquan Sampson back in the game.
Matroni sees no one under the net. He takes it in with the left hand and finishes. Nice drive by number 55, Matroni. As the Bison are going to take a quick, looking like a 30-second timeout. Max Matroni.
I'll tell you, he is.
This kid can play his heart out.
He is a bad man, Max Matroni.
Just great court awareness. Head was up, dribbling with the left hand. Seeing he was just being guarded by Dion, the shooting guard for the Bison. Noticed Cunningham was a little late getting back, also stalling. See no one in the lane. Knew he can beat his man one-on-one. Took it right to the rack and laid it in.
Yeah,
textbook.
Yeah, I mean, I said I like that matchup with Matroni and Dion. I mean, obviously, they're going to give Dion a little bit of help there with Motroni, which we've
seen. And
so
Matroni's
often.
Not a guy you want to guard one-on-one, and that's great confidence from him, though. And if he's guarding one-on-one with no help, he knows he can beat his man and get to the rim.
Exactly. He is an incredible athlete. Great two-way player.
Drew Sawyer checks back in here for the Gulls. He guards Echevarria now. Echevarria to his left. Tips it out, stolen by Walker. Tipped away, nope. The Bison recover. Antoine for three. And that's off the back of the rim. Rebounded by Walker, and he wants to run. Euros into the lane with the left hand and in. Nice Euro step at number two, Kamal Walker. I haven't seen Nichols play with a lot of as much speed as they were playing with last night. I mean, I wonder if fatigue has anything to do with that. Cunningham stalks, spins back to his right. Great defense by Sampson. Tip back up to Cunningham, who lays it in.
Sampson can't do much with that, especially with two fouls.
Cunningham wincing a little bit as he gets back on D. That was great defense by Sampson. Couldn't grab the rebound, unfortunately. Walker drives with his left under the baseline. Finds Motroni. To Sampson, he drives. Back to Motroni. Got a foul on the floor. It's going to be number two, Daquan Antoine. That'll be his second, team third. Sorry, that'll be Antoine's first foul, not second. My apologies. Motroni to inbound. Lobs it out to Lipscomb. Walker. Nice feed under the net. Motroni for three. And that's good. Nothing but net. Max Motroni. The extra pass, Matt.
I'll tell you, that is something that Endicott does so well. And it's move the ball around.
Bruton drives, finds Cunningham, defended well by Lipscomb. And he lays it in for two. Jerome Cunningham getting after it on the low block for Nichols. Sawyer drives, throws it out to Lipscomb. Clifford wants another one for three, and that's off the back of the rim. Rebounded by Echevarria. He drives, he gets in, lobs it up with the right hand, and it's no good. Matroni, jab step, goes to his right now, gets in the lane, no help, and lays it in for the easy deuce. Nichols' defense stucks ball watching, no one slid over to help.
Cunningham fell asleep.
You're right, Matt. He literally did not move there to help out.
I looked like Jahlil Okafor the other night.
Oh, Jesus. Don't even get me started on Okafor. Dion for three. This kid can shoot, ladies and gentlemen. He's five of his last five in this NCAA tournament from beyond the arc.
100% to start his tournament.
Is the freshman Tyler Dion. This kid can shoot. Great drive by Lipscomb along the baseline. He's fouled by Cunningham. He'll go to line to shoot too. So we'll head to another media timeout under four. Stallings will check back in for the Bison. Matt, I'm a little bit shocked here. This, it looked like this fast-paced offense so far is favoring Endicott instead of Nichols College.
Yeah, which, I mean, like you were stating with the fact, I mean, how many minutes Nichols played, or their starters played yesterday, it could really have a major impact here, especially getting later into the game, especially going towards the second half. Endicott's playing with a lot of energy here. The ball movement is just excellent. And, you know, they're doing everything right on both ends of the floor. You know, so, I mean, hands down to Endicott so far here early on. And, you know, I mean, they lost two or three this year to their conference rivals, so, you know, they're in to try to split this series up, especially in the biggest matchup this year between them.
That's how college basketball works, guys. Conference games are always tough.
I love
home, away, neutral site, doesn't matter. Conference games in this sport are tough.
Yes, they are.
Extremely hard fought. Just under 3.5 to play in the first half here in the NCAA tournament second round. We have the Endicott Gulls leading the Nichols College Bison 43-38. As it's Lipscomb who will step to the line to shoot two for Endicott. As Cunningham takes a break. Misses the front end here. And Lipscomb hits the second. That'll give him 13 on the night as he is the leading scorer for the Endicott Gulls. Dion wants three more, and he misses. He is human. That's Faria for three. Jesus, and that's good. This team can shoot.
Can't give them second chance points.
That three will give that Javaria 13 as he leads the way for the scoring for the Gulls. Motroni answers with a deep two.
There goes that man again. Max Motroni, ladies and
gentlemen. Mama, men. There goes that man. Max Motroni.
Got him with an illegal screen.
I don't know if that, if they're going to say he stepped out of bounds, maybe. I didn't see a foul call. Not necessarily sure what the whistle was for, but we have a turnover. We'll give the ball back to Endicott. My guess is maybe Dion stepped out.
Yeah, that.
They were along that sideline by the bench. Off Walker's hands. Basden recovers for the Gulls. Petroni wants three more. Rims out. Good rebound by Nate Tardy. Just over two to play in the first half. Echevarria dials it up for three, and that's good. Marcos Echevarria. That'll give him 16. Walker wants three more. They're going to have it over the back foul and the rebound on Keith Brown, which gives the ball back to Nichols College. Sorry, that'll give Echevarria 13, I believe.
16.
Oh, 16, I was right. Echevarria having a huge first half here for the Bison. A guy coming off of first round NCAA tournament game where he played all 40 minutes. And here he is leading them in scoring the very next night. Very impressive. Just a sophomore. Bruton up and under. Long rebounded by Lipscomb. Here goes Motroni. He wants to run. Try to initiate contact. Doesn't get the call. Motroni drives. Finds Lipscomb. 7 on the shot clock. Motroni the open three, and that's good. Max Motroni for three.
That is excellent ball.
That gives him 16 now for Endicott. Echevarria from deep, rimmed out. Motroni runs again. Eurostep, nice move, lays it in and one. What a move. Echevarria does not like the call, saying he was straight up. Nonetheless, it'll count. Max Motroni, folks. Bringing it again tonight. Checking in for the first time this tournament will be number one, Joel Villa. as Walker takes a break for the Gulls. Vinny Clifford checks back in.
I'll tell you, this guy is 5'10", all heart.
Completes the three-point play. That gives him 19 and a half. And, just under a minute left to play.
My prediction of the biggest league going to seven is out of the picture now. It's up to eight.
That's Maria drives that was left. Nate Tardy wants three. That's off the back of the rim. Tipped, rebounded by Basden. 35 to play here. It's Lipscomb. Back to Motroni. 25 to play, 15 on the shot clock. Motroni settles. Looking maybe for an iso here. Guarded by Bruton. Five on the clock. Motroni from deep. Unbelievable. Give him all three of those. Max Motroni gives him 22 in the half. Telling the Endicott crowd to let's go. Stallings at the buzzer. And that's off the back of the rim. What a way to close out the half if you were the Endicott Gulls as they lead by 11 here at the half. Unbelievable.
That is an incredible way to end a half there as they extend their lead to double digits here, and Nichols has a lot of work to do here in the second half. It is going to be, I mean, Endicott does it all well. The ball movement is the greatest I've seen in a long time with them, but it's incredible to watch. Max Motroni having himself an incredible first half.
What I'm noticing different in Endicott's offense tonight, they're scoring a lot from the perimeter. They did yesterday as well, but tonight they're just shooting exceptionally well because they're wide open. I'm seeing double back screens along the back block, letting Motroni pop to the corner, doing a couple dribble crossovers, step back, getting space. And right now, when you're in that zone, the rim's got to look like the ocean. Yeah. Throwing a ball right in. It looks that big for Motroni right now. That last three was from NBA range. Nothing but net.
Max Motroni, I mean, he is just, I mean, he's doing it all points-wise, but he's creating as well. You know, I mean, there's, especially the three-point attempts from Clifford. Lost his name.
Yeah, Vinny Clifford.
Yeah, but the three-pointers from him came from.
Huge spark, yep.
Yeah, it came from Motroni feeding, but. I'll tell you, Nichols has a tough task to go here in the second half. So
they are down 11. Going into the half is Nichols College. But as we've seen from them last night, this team doesn't go anywhere. They'll be right back, right in your face, guarding you tight. They can make this a two-point game in seconds. That's how electrifying their offense can be.
Yeah, no question. I mean, can't get that name again.
Echevarria. You're gonna have nightmares about this name, Matt.
I am. I'm gonna be saying it for the next 2 weeks.
About 13 and a half left until we come back with the second half. I'm Zach Ford. I'm accompanied by my color analyst, Matt Cox. We will be right back in about 13 for second half action here at the Miranda Center.
NCAA championships and the educational and athletic experiences of nearly half a million NCAA student athletes. Hey fans, take home a souvenir from tonight's championship action. Visit the NCAA merchandise stands located in the main atrium of the Miranda Center for great championship gear and memorabilia. Once again, souvenir stand located in the main atrium of the building. You can also access the official NCAA digital game program on your mobile device, tablet, or laptop free of charge. Visit ncaa.com/gameprograms, ncaa.com/gameprograms for an inside look at today's championship action. And did you know that more than 50,000 student-athletes compete in NCAA championships at more than 800 sites across the country? Find a championship near you? Visit ncaa.com/tickets. ncaa.com/tickets. Hey, fans, there are only 9 items remaining at the merchandise stand in the main atrium of the building. Limited sizes and items are available. So if you're thinking about making a purchase, I would highly recommend you go out to the atrium and take a look at the selection. Once again, only 9 items remaining at the merchandise table. Take a look and hopefully take home a souvenir. I will fly.
there is me.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Newman University Miranda Center for second round action of the 2017 Division III NCAA tournament. We have the Endicott Gulls leading the Nichols College Bison by 11, 55-44 after the first half. Matt, let's talk about some highlights in the first half here.
Yeah, I mean, I'll tell you, the way to beat this Nichols College team is to shoot with them, and Endicott is right now shooting better than them. They are shooting an incredible 60% from the field right now, as Nichols is shooting about just over 47%. So they're just Endicott's outplaying Nichols. So, but like you mentioned at the end of the first half, Nichols does not go away, and we saw that here yesterday. So
both teams start the second half the same way they started the first, as Nichols possesses. That's Rhea for three, pulls the trigger, and that's good. Picking up right where he left off in the first half. Marcos Echevarria, as Nichols comes out and looking like a full court 2-2-1 press here. Little trapping press. Basden gets it to Sampson. Lipscomb. Over to Basden. He drives the baseline, finds Motroni. To Walker for the corner three, and that's good. The extra pass once again proving the workout very well for Endicott. Matroni had the open look, gave it up to Walker, knocks it down. Really unselfish play.
Just when you think Nichols can get a sparker going, Endicott answers right back.
That's Bree with a quick crossover. He pulls up from two. He's fouled on the shot by number 13, Steven Basden. That'll send Echevarria to the line to shoot two.
Guy was perfect from the line last night, 10 for 10. Has not shot a free throw yet in this game, so this will be his first two.
Like you said, 10 for 10. A lot of his free throws coming at the end of the game, too. Clutch time, knocking him down to seal the win for Nichols. Right back where he left off as well from the line as he hits the first free throw. That'll make him 11 for 11 from the line for the tournament. It's a great sign if you're Nichols, if you can get this game to a little bit closer here at the end. Nichols try to send him to the line whenever they want. As he hits the second one, nothing but net. They'll stay in the 2-2-1 press. Matroni beats it. He finds Walker. Walker drives with his left. Right hand takes the contact and lays it in. Kamal Walker with a big bucket for Endicott. Kamal Walker, 32 points last night in the win over Salisbury. Really did the most of his damage in the second half. Cunningham looks, spins, tipped, great defense by Sampson. And here comes Endicott. Walker gets in the lane, spins back to his left hand, gives it up to Lipscomb, he drives. Matroni drives. Basden from the baseline, that's no good, rebounded by Cunningham.
Tell you, just unselfish basketball for this Bulls team.
Bruton drives to his left. He's fouled with a reach by number 13, Basden. That'll be his second, team's second, here early in the second half, 2 minutes in. Stallings. He finds Bruton. He drives to his right. Steps back. Gets it into the paint to Cunningham. He turns up and under. Great defense by Sampson. Echevarria for three. Wants contact. No call.
Ball doesn't lie.
Bruton wants three now. And that's long. Rebounded by Walker. Walker looks to penetrate the lane. Sampson on the baseline, no good. Rebounded by Stallings. Tipped away, stolen. He's fouled on the shot by Cunningham. Instead of getting up the easy bucket, Cunningham just grabs him by the waist with two hands.
How about the job Max Matroni's done on Deontay Bruton tonight? Bruton only 6 points after an incredible game last night.
Yeah, Bruton has been slow thus far, but like a lot of these guys on Nichols, he can get going just like that as Walker knocks down the first free throw for the Gulls. And he hits the second. That'll give Endicott the 13-point lead. That'll give Walker 13 on the night. Bruton drives to his left. He looks. He finds Cunningham in the post. Spin move. Bumped. Swatted away by Sampson. Matroni drives. In the Walker. Blocked on the backboard by Cunningham. Great defense by the freshman. Dion dials it up for three. That's short. Rebounded. Great rebound by Sampson here. Endicott runs. Matroni for three. Give them all three of these. What a find by number two, Kamal Walker, as it's Matroni that gives him 25 on the night. That's Maria to answer. Nats off the rim, rebounded by Sampson as he's fouled, pulled down from behind by Cunningham. Cunningham gives him a stare down. A couple of choice words by the freshman.
Cunningham is not having his way tonight, and he's not happy about it.
That'll be his third on Cunningham, team second.
Things are starting to get feisty here, is what we expect from conference rivals.
Walker to his right. Gets it inside to Basden. He finds Sampson from the corner for three, and he wants off three of those. It's number four to Quan Sampson.
What a major impact.
19-point lead. Gonna reach in foul number two, Kamal Walker, as we go to our first media timeout under 16. Those of you just checking in, just under 16 minutes left in the second half here, the second round of the tournament. We have Endicott leading the Nichols College Bison 68-49. Matt, what's happened so far early here in the second half?
Endicott just continues doing what they did well in the first half. That's moving the ball around, and they're executing on wide open shots, which, you know, they, like I said, they shot 60% from the field in the first half, and they're just not slowing down. They, you know, I mean, playing back-to-back games is not an easy thing, and, you know, they're showing a lot of energy here. I don't know what was in their cereal this morning, but it is incredible to watch here.
Plenty of game left, just under 16 left to play, but it's evident so far. It just looks like, simply enough, that Endicott just wants this more, wants this game more than them. They're scrapping harder, they're running harder, they're doing little things right now, and unfortunately, it's not the same way for Nichols. Nichols is, they're forcing a lot of tough shots. And that just goes to show how great of a defensive team Endicott can be when they're in their zone and they're locking up, forcing a lot of easy jump shots for Nichols, maybe making them a little bit uncomfortable.
Especially when Daquan Sampson's in that lineup with them.
Such a different team when he's in. It's a great call. Didn't get to see much of number four Sampson last night as he struggled with fouls the entire game. Finished with only 3 points. Dion for three, and that's good. The sharpshooter, freshman number three, Tyler Dion, from beyond the arc.
I tell you, 6 of 7 here in the tournament from 3-point range.
Walker wants three on the answer, and that's long. Rebounded by Lipscomb. Back to Matrone, he drives, steps back. Finds Walker. Matroni pulls up deep two. It's going to be short. Good box out, a rebound by Echeverria. He drives with right hand. Gets caught under the net, throws it away, turns it over. Here comes Walker with his left hand. Finds Motroni for three, and that's good. Max Motroni, give him 28. He is fired up. Three-point attempt missed. Rebounded by Lipscomb.
Max Motroni wants that triple-double. He wanted that rebound.
Sampson again for three, and that's good. Daquan Sampson. Endicott is unconscious from the field. 22-point lead for the Gulls. Bruton answers from deep three. That's a rough shot, and that's rebounded by Sampson. Basden pulls up, and that's good for two. Timeout Nichols. The Endicott Gulls, folks, are running away with it.
They are just not slowing down at all. This team is rolling right now.
Nichols just looks dead, Matt. No energy, no fight left in him, it looks like, as of right now. Still 14 to play, but this is all Endicott so far.
Yeah, Nichols, the last few possessions, they've just forced up tough shots. You know, it's well defended by Endicott. And you know, I mean, this team, what we've seen from them, you know, they're a three-point shooting team. Endicott's covered on that line extremely well and taken away what Nichols College does best. So it's just been a great all-around performance here from Endicott, and Nichols has a lot of work to do.
And unfortunately for the Bison, down 24 here with 14 left to play, they're going to have to start not necessarily forcing shots, but they're going to have to start taking some shots they're not necessarily that comfortable taking. They got to get back in this game. They got to find a spark from someone.
Yeah, I'd be putting
no life in them at the moment.
I'd be putting it in the hands of Echeverria. I think I got it down that time.
Nate Tardy on the Nichols College bench trying to get his guys fired up, saying, let's go, guys. Someone's got to give this team a spark here. Bruton finds Cunningham. Hands off to Echeverria. He lays it in for two. Marcos Echeverria, he's been doing it all here for the Bison. That gives him 23 on the night as Marcos Echeverria. Motroni to Sampson. Gives it up to Lipscomb. Walker for the open three. And that's off the back of the rim, rebounded by Lipscomb. Walker, a lot of contact, and he's fouled by Cunningham. That'll be his fourth. As he'll take a seat, looks like. As Josiah Kimball takes off the warm-up, looks like he's ready to check back in. That'll be his fourth, team third. Sends Kamal Walker to the line for the goals of Endicott. Hits it first.
And that is going to be a big loss, losing Jerome Cunningham.
Cunningham takes some rest, as well as Devin Stallings, the 4-5 starters for Nichols College. And Walker hits the second. 24-point lead here for Endicott. Just over 13 to play in the second half. Dion drives, dumps it into Kimball, it's tipped, gets his own miss, lays it up, and he's fouled. Foul's going to go on number 13, Steven Basden. That'll send Kimball to the line to shoot two. That'll be the team fourth.
Not a lot of fouls being called in this game here. The refs are letting them play tonight.
Kimball misses the first as Keith Brown checks back in for Endicott. Basden takes a seat. Nice Misses the second as well, rebounded by Sampson. Kimball not happy with himself. Petroni through the legs, goes to his left hand. Finds Lipscomb along the baseline. Back, great pass to Keith Brown, lays it up for the easy deuce.
I'll tell you, this Nichols College team is confused on the defensive side of the ball.
Bruton's bump, lays it in. They're going to count it and one. Nice drive by the freshman Bruton. Takes the contact and lays it up anyway.
That's a way to try to get your team back into it.
As Drew Sawyer checks back in for Kamal Walker. Bruton's got to try to catch fire here. As he hits, completes the three-point play. That'll give him 9 on the night. Max Matroni gets into the lane. He's stripped, fouled by Kimball. Foul be on number 12. Josiah Kimball will be his first. Team fourth sends Matroni to the line to shoot two. As he hits the first free throw. Matroni looks like he can play another game after this, Matt.
Matroni has a lot of fans here, too.
Hits the second. That'll give him 30 on the night. Echevarria for 3, knows it short, runs in, tips his own rebound. Great hustle. Nichols keeps it. Great hustle on the by Echevarria, realizing his shot was going to come up short. Hustle and in, tipping the ball away, forcing the ball to go off of Endicott. Inbounded to Kimball, gets it back to the point guard, Bruton. Kimball looks to screen. Kimball drives with his right. Lays it up for 2. Tough basket by Josiah Kimball. Matroni guarded tough by Echevarria. Brown across court to Sawyer. He's fouled. Kimball again. He doesn't like the call. That'll send Drew Sawyer to line to shoot 2 as we head to our second media timeout under 12 minutes here.
As much as I believe in miracles, I am not liking Nichols' chance here coming back in this thing. As they trail by 23 here, I mean.
If Nichols had Tom Brady, I would say there's a chance.
Yeah, you think Tom Brady can play basketball?
I think Tom Brady can do anything.
I don't doubt that.
I think he can do anything and probably win at it. If you're just tuning in, we're just under 12 left to play in the second half of the second round of the NCAA tournament. Endicott College leading Nichols College 82-59. It's been all Matroni here for the Gulls. He leads the way with 30 points.
Yeah, I mean, it just Nichols cannot seem to find any type of run here. It just every time they get something going, Endicott answers right back, and it seems like a game that we just watched last night.
And you said it earlier; it's a great point. This Endicott team looks completely different offensively as well as defensively when number 4 Daquan Sampson is in the game, not in foul trouble. He's been a huge factor for them. He's forcing a lot of tough shots from Cunningham down on the block. He's defended him extremely well tonight, I think.
He has.
And doing so without fouling, that's got to be a great sign if you're Endicott.
Yeah, and he can shoot as well. He is an incredible
shooter. He's knocked down 2 threes tonight. As Drew Sawyer hits the first free throw. Cunningham, the freshman phenom of Nichols, still sits with 4. Sawyer's second attempt up, and it's out, and it's rim. It rims out, rebounded. Very aggressive rebound by Echevarria. He drives, nice drive, lays it up with the right hand, just off, rebounded by Kimball. He's going to be fouled on the way to for the tip-in. It's going to be on number five, Max Motroni. That'll send Kimmel to the line to shoot two. Tell you what, Echeverria is quick.
He is. He flew right by Motroni.
Did a little hesitation dribble, and then I blinked and missed him, and he was already in the lane. After playing 40 minutes last night. Kimball struggling from the line here in the second half. He's 0 of his last three. He's going to take a step back to take a breather, regroup. And you often wonder if they could have missed some of these last night. Maybe the outcome of the Newman-Nichols game could be a little bit different here.
Yeah, I mean,
as Kimball hits the second.
The free throws were definitely a huge portion of that. And, you know, Newman, who is a 65%. Free throw shooting team the entire year. You knew once it came tournament time, they would have to figure a way to knock them down. Oh, he got away with a lot of shifting his feet there.
Motroni blows right by Dion. Finds Drew Sawyer from the corner. Short, rebounded by Lipscomb. Gets his own miss. Motroni possesses, looks to facilitate. He finds Sawyer. Sawyer drives with the left hand. It's Keith Brown in the corner. And that's off. Rebounded again by Echeverria. He falls. Remains his dribble. Unbelievable. Lays it in for two.
That's incredible.
And a quick timeout by Nichols. What a drive. Like Marcos Echeverria. Falls completely down. Remains. Keeps the dribble alive. Gets up to his feet and gets the easy bucket. Great job. 11 even left to play in the second half. Endicott leads Nichols College 83-62. Winner of this will move on to the Sweet 16.
Yeah, the winner of this will play the winner between Middlebury and...
It's like Lycoming?
Lycoming. I am not having an easy task with names here.
It's all right. These are tough words. Going to be Endicott ball after the quick Nichols College timeout. It's going to be Clifford inbound. Nichols pick it up in a full court man-to-man bump just on the inbound. Echeverria guards Motroni. Motroni for three, and that's on the rims out. Rebounded by Dion. It's actually weird watching him miss. Antoine for three, and that's short. Gets his own miss. Trapped in the corner. Pegs it into Kimball. Stolen by Sampson. Matroni's running. No one stops ball. He gets to the lane. Lays it in for two with the left hand.
Two Nichols College players collided there.
Great move by Bruton. Going to have a reach before the shot. Going to go on, not sure just yet, just a second. Okay, it's going to go on Vinny Clifford. That'll be his first team sixth. Bosden checks back in for Endicott. Stallings checks back in for Nichols. Cunningham still sits with four, just over 10 left to play in the second half. Sorry, that was actually the team's seventh for Endicott, so that forces Bruton to shoot the one-and-one as he hits the first there in the bonus. And he hits his second as well. Deontay Bruton, 2 for 2 from the line. Basden guarded tough by Stallings. Basden finds Walker back to Motroni. To Clifford for three, and that's good. It's Vinny Clifford's fourth three from beyond the arc off the bench for Endicott.
I'll tell you, have yourself a game, Vinny Clifford.
Kimball gives it up to Echeverria. He pulls from three. He's fouled. Walker doesn't like the call. That'll send Atchebria to the line to shoot three. Tough break for Endicott. That'll be Walker's fourth. Looks like he's going to take a rest here. First to 10 for Echevarria, and that's off. Rare miss from the line for Echevarria.
His perfect streak ends.
Hits the second. Drew Sawyer checks back in for Endicott as Walker sits with four. Third attempt here for Echevarria. And that's good. Two out of three from the line and a three-shot foul is Echevarria as he guards Motroni now full court. Clifford to Sawyer. Sampson along the baseline. Great pass inside. DeBazden lays it in for two. Great feed by Sampson. Rutan pulls up. Nothing but air there. Rebounded by Motroni. He drives. Stripped by Echevarria. It's going to stay with Endicott. The other ref seen something different. They're actually going to change it. Ball's going to go to Nichols here. Must have had a better view with it as the freshman Jerome Cunningham checks back in playing with four fouls.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing else to lose here with 9 minutes to play.
Echevarria drives. Swings it out to Stallings for three. That's short. Rebounded again by Motroni. He wants to run. Settles it up. Finds Sawyer. Great bounce pass to Basden. Blocked off the backboard by Cunningham. Great defense. That's Rhea lobs it in to Cunningham. Little long tip out of bounds. Goes back to Endicott on the turnover. Antoine checks back in for Echevarria as he gets his first break here of the entire tournament. He's got to be gassed. Go. 73 minutes without a sub, Matt, is Echevarria, just about.
That's incredible.
Sawyer, give him all three of those. Drew Sawyer for three. 27-point lead here for Endicott. Bruton for two. It's good. Just like that, Echevarria is getting ready to check back in. Quick 30-second break here for the sophomore guard. Good defense, stolen by Daquan Antoine. He's on the break. Met at the rim by Sampson, great D. Antoine lays it off the bottom of the backboard.
He wanted no piece of Sampson.
No way, Vinny Clifford. Gonna say he wants another one. Tipped out of bounds, stays with Endicott. Under eight, we'll go to another media timeout. As Endicott handing a huge effort to Nicholas College. They're up 93-68, Matt.
Yeah, it has been all Endicott in this thing, and I actually have an update for us between Middlebury and Lycoming. Middlebury's leading that one 75-56 with just over 10 minutes to play, so looks like Middlebury could be seeing Endicott in the Sweet 16. Unless Tom Brady's son or something plays for Lycoming.
I Nichols still just has not found that spark that they needed. Once they started trailing by double digits, they basically fell apart.
Yeah, it's
no, not a lot of fight left in them. And once Endicott took the lead, they kept their foot on the pedal and just kept giving it to them the entire game.
It was, I mean, really, the first 5 minutes when Endicott started going on that run, it was just poor shot selection from Nichols.
You're right. Yep, good call.
And I mean, they have great, or Nichols College has great shooters out here, but when you're not moving the ball around, it's not going to be easy to find shots.
Joel Villa checks back in for Endicott. Sawyer for three, and that's good. Another three for number 11, Drew Sawyer.
And everybody on the floor for Endicott touched the ball at least once.
Greg Popovich-style offense here for Endicott, wanting everybody to get involved. Nice drive by Cunningham. He's fouled by Sampson as Cunningham will go to the line to shoot two.
That's only Sampson's third foul.
Impressive. What a turnaround from last night. He couldn't breathe without getting a foul called on him. Cunningham misses the front end. Motroni checks back in. Cunningham to attempt a second. And that's good. That's really not paying attention. Motroni runs right by him. No damage, though, as they settle into a defense. It's Basden to Motroni. Motroni shovels his feet, no call. Sampson for three, and that's long. Rebounded. Dion recovers. It's Bruton now. Great defense, tipped by Basden. Motroni recovers. Another wasted possession here for Nichols. As Motroni, one of the only negative things I've seen him do the entire tournament, he turned it over.
I don't even know if that was his fault. It kind of looked like 24 kind of just didn't make an effort towards the ball.
Looks like a little miscommunication there. Echeverria drives the right now. He floats it up off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Basden. The ball's tipped by Echeverria. They're going to call a foul, and he is irate. That'll be his third, team sixth. As he clutches his hand, looks like he might have jammed a finger on the steal attempt. 3-1-1, full court press here. The trap works, they get a steal. It's Bruton. Echeverria wide open from three, and that's wide. Rebounded by Lipscomb, he fights as he's fouled. Looks like it's gonna be on.
They got Cunningham.
No, they're gonna get tardy here. Number 24, that'll be his first. Team ninth. I'm sorry, team seventh. That'll send Lipscomb to the line here to shoot the front end of a 1-1.
I think all those minutes for Echeverria is starting to catch up to him now.
He's got to be fatigued to play that hard for this many minutes.
Yeah, I mean, he's been incredible.
He's balls to the wall in every single possession, so he's got to be exhausted. Misses the second one is Lipscomb, rebounded by Echeverria. He spins. Defended tight by Basden. Dion for three. That's short. They're going to have a foul. It's going to go on Tardy. I'm trying to think here. Yeah, it's going to be on Tardy again. As Lipscomb's knocked out of bounds on the rebound attempt. game like this, a little bit of a blowout. I hope it doesn't get out of hand here, Matt.
Yeah, I mean.
But physically.
Yeah, I mean.
I'm saying. There's a lot of games you see blowout. It's a tournament. You're about to be done for the year. A lot of teams just stop caring. Maybe some dirty fouls. I'm hoping the game doesn't end up like this.
Yeah, I mean, especially with conference rivalry matchups.
Oh, man. Yeah. Sure. These guys are probably sick of each other. So, what is this, their fourth time playing?
Yep. And the Cats going to get away with winning the big one, the one that matters.
Yeah. These guys played a couple weeks ago with Endicott and Nichols in their conference championship. Nichols, on the positive end, winning by three. Here in the tournament, Matt, not the same story.
Yeah, it was definitely a different result here, as we still have just under six minutes to play here, but you know, Endicott has completely taken full control of this thing and looks like they're going to wrap up this thing and move on to the Sweet 16.
Another thing I noticed is the conditioning of the two teams. I said it earlier, but it looks like Endicott could actually play another game after this. And on the other hand, Nichols, they just look extremely lethargic here. It's obviously going to come down to them playing back-to-back nights, but it's just seeing the difference in stamina by the two teams is actually pretty incredible.
I'll tell you, I'm questioning Echeverria's presence right now in this game. He looks hurt.
Yeah, he's got his hands on his knees. He's either gassed or he's injured. Cunningham, nice drive. He's fouled by Sampson. That'll send Cunningham back to the line.
He's been limping the last couple of possessions. So, I mean, right now, you know, with a 30-point lead, I know you're hoping for miracles here as the Nicholas College head coach, but you got to think, he's a sophomore. You got to worry about his health right now.
Cunningham long on the first attempt. Just looks like two different teams in these two games here for Nichols, unfortunately. Misses the second one the same way, long off the back of the rim. It's rebounded by Basden for Endicott. He looks ahead. No one in the corner. Lipscomb gives it out to kill some clock. Lipscomb's not giving this one up. Hits the three. Chris Lipscomb. 102-69 as the blowout continues here in round two. Echeverria to answer, and that's good. Rattles it home. That'll give Echeverria 30 on the night. He's doing all he can for this Bison team. Motroni drives in, lays it in with the right hand. That'll give him 34. Bruton spins. Goes up with the right hand. Off the back of the rim and off. Rebounded by Motroni again. Sampson finds Basden driving. He goes up to the left. Count it and one.
The exclamation point. Even though I think that was stamped about 10 minutes ago.
Cunningham takes a seat. Was that his fifth, Matt? Was that on him?
I'm not sure. I don't even think Cunningham is back there. I think it's just time for the bench.
Yeah, it looks like Nichols is going to start unloading their bench here. This one just happens to be out of reach. They're going to bring in the senior, number 21, Brandon Marshall. Also, we'll bring in number 5, the junior Jared Thompson. Motroni, Lipscomb, Walker, Sampson take a seat for the goals. Well deserved. Both teams starting to unload their bench here. Checking in for Endicott for the first time tonight. We number 44, Christian Mornowek. He played some minutes yesterday, Matt, as Samson struggled with fouls. This is his first action here tonight. That's Varia from deep. That's wide. Rebounded by Sawyer. Gets it up to Joel Villa. Takes the contact, lays it up wide. Can be rebounded by Echevarria. That'll give him 8 rebounds. Stolen by Sawyer.
I think Echevarria just
gave Echevarria is going to sub him. He looks hurt here, Matt. We head to our under 4 media timeout. Jerome Cunningham looks like he's going to be out for the game. The freshman phenom from Nichols. He'll finish with the double-double, Matt. 11 points, 10 rebounds. Good outing from him. And it's basically been him and Echevarria and Bruton, just like last night.
Yeah, I mean.
Tyler Dion's been quiet. He has 6.
Yeah, Tyler Dion was just not able to find a lot of space tonight. And, you know, Endicott defense playing well overall around the perimeter, shooting and keeping Nicholas College quiet from out there, and it's just has not been the same team that we saw last night.
Endicott showing their more diverse scoring as well. Last night it was all Walker. He finished with 32 for Endicott. Tonight he's only got 15, but Chris Lipscomb stepped up. He's got 19 for the goals. And our man Max Motroni carrying the way with 34.
I'll tell you, I'm gonna miss him here at the Marine.
I'm gonna miss him too. He's fun to watch.
What are the chances we could try to... Oh, wait, now he's a senior this year.
Yeah, he is.
Say, recruiting him to Newman.
Transfer. Checking in now for Endicott. Oh, not yet. Looks like it's going to be number 5, Joe Shahadi. And that's good from Sawyer as Shahadi checks in. This is Osby. Deep 2. That's wide. Nothing but air. Tebow checks back in for Endicott. Mornowack. Finds number 12. Matthew Catazone. Shahadi. Villa settles it down, 6 on the shot clock. He drives, nice drive with the right hand up and under, no good. Mornowack recovers. Good rebound, he'll go to the line. He's fouled by Osby. Christian Mornowack goes to the line to shoot 2. Just under 3 left to play. Ref's having a conversation, you know, not sure what on. Get that to you as soon as I find out. They're going to change who the foul is on. It's actually going to be on Brandon Marshall, number 21. Mornowack, long on the first one. Second attempt up. And that's long. Rebounded by Marshall. It's Thompson here. Drives to his right, loses control of the ball, and that goes out of bounds. Back to Endicott. Catazone gives it up. Finds Shahadi. Mornowack wants 3. That's long. Rebounded by Osby. 2.5 left to play.
I was curious if this Endicott magic could continue off the bench as well.
That'd be impressive as Thompson throws it away. Tebow finds Villa. Finds Mornowack in the along the baseline. Seven on the clock. Catazone, the freshman, drives baseline. He finds Tebow for three. That's long. Rebounded by Villa. As he smart decision and settles it up. And we got a fresh shot clock now. It's Catazone back down the baseline. Villa finds Mornowack to the freshman Catazone for three. That's good. Nothing but cotton for the freshman Catazone.
I'll tell you, even the bench with incredible ball movement.
We're the real bench mob. Stallings for three, the senior. That's long. Great rebound by Tardy. He's going to be fouled by, looks like 22, Nick Tebow. Minute 21 left to play. Endicott 111-72, the lead over Nichols College. Tardy misses the first off the back of the rim. The freshman, Devin Stalling, checks out, looks up for the final time. Great ovation from his teammates, coaches, and fans. It's a good sight. It's a cool gesture by the coach checking him out so he can get the ovation he deserves. Great career at Nichols College for Devin Stallings. Jihadi stripped. It's Tardy, coast to coast, lays it in with the right hand. Nice finish by Nate Tardy. That is a nice drive. Up and under on the baseline. It's short. It's Osby. He wants three. Off the backboard and off. 33 to play left. It's Brendan Johnson. He's fouled by Tardy. But I'll send him to the line to shoot two.
So after top and the number 16 team in the nation, Salisbury, Endicott just coming back with another excellent performance.
Nichols coming in with a lot of momentum, winning the conference tournament, coming in, knocking off the number 11 ranked Newman Knights, coming in with a lot of momentum, and it just, Endicott hit him in the mouth 5 minutes in, and they just did not look back. .14 to play, shot clock off, Nichols ball. Tardy drives, nice drive, and it's blocked by Tebow. He spins, that's blocked. Brendan Johnson recovers, 5 to play. He gets it to Tebow, and folks, that'll do it. The Endicott goals knock off the Nichols College Bison, and they will head to the Sweet 16. Nichols College on a great season. Didn't end the way they wanted, but nothing for them to be ashamed about. They're a young team, Matt. I wouldn't be surprised to see them right back here next year.
Yeah, I'll tell you, they have a bright future. There's going to be a lot of players holding their heads down, especially on that long trip back home. But, you know, they, with the young freshmen that they have and the talent that they have remaining on this team, they will definitely be back here, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them make a far run in years to come.
And the chemistry with these young guys is so prominent, and it's there already, and they're only freshmen, so it'll be fun to watch. Yeah. But what a job by Endicott.
Yeah, I'll tell you, they played lights out. They were here to play today, and I mean, I'm not here to make excuses for anyone. I mean, Endicott, all around, great performance, but you kind of have to think with Nicholls College. They got a huge win here last night, but how much did that take out of them playing number 11 team in Newman?
Yeah, they looked a little fatigued, Matt. Throughout the entire game, Echevarria is getting iced now. He looks like he was a little banged up, but he really gave the team all he had tonight. He scored 30 points. Can't ask for more out of him. No one else could really get the spark rolling for him, so
yeah, it was
gotta feel bad for Echevarria.
It was an incredible run as they won the CCC Conference Championship, but Endicott has the last laugh here as they will move on to the Sweet 16, and Nicholls College will be heading home.
So after the first and second round action here, first time ever having the tournament at the Miranda Center, I'm Zach Ford, this is Matt Cox, NSN. We're going to get out of here. Enjoy your weekend.
It was a pleasure to be here, everyone. Take care.